Chris, how would you describe what the Internet of Value is and what the sort of insight is to get us there?
Yeah, so a lot of it came from kind of the early work you guys did with pathfinding, and again, having this, you know, anything of value can be traded. That kind of was the germ of it. But kind of stepping way back, if you look at the real problem in the world today, you know, a lot of people point to globalization as being, you know, not working for people. And we would say, no, it's not that it's not working, it's just that it's a work in progress, right? It's incomplete. So we could have a real globalization needs interoperability in, you know, three core things, right? Data, goods, shipping, and money. And the problem is it only has interoperability in data, obviously the internet, and shipping since the 50s with the shipping container, which creates interoperability between port to other port, you know, ship to train to truck. But you don't have that with money. Money networks don't interoperate. And if you have that, now billions of people are onboarded into a real working, you know, kind of system of globalization. And that's upon us. I think that's really what we're trying to build here.
And I think the need is very, very evident now because you have companies that have very, very light infrastructure or none in the areas they serve.
You know, if you talk to folks at the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation who do a ton of work in the financial infrastructure, you know, of the world, you know, the big thing that they're trying to accomplish is to allow people to send as little as 50 cents, you know, somebody in the developing world, if they're really going to be a participant in the global economy. And that's just impossible today, right? I mean, even it's really even impossible to send 50 bucks from the US to Europe without it being all chewed up in fees. 50 cents is just not on the table. But in a world now, this kind of internet of value, combining things like ILP and XRP, that is absolutely possible. That is, you know, so frictionless and so fast, it completely changes the economics. And then beyond, you know, those billions of people that need to send 50 cents, think about the trillions of devices and code that needs to be able to send, you know, 1/10,000th of a cent. That is also enabled through what's going on here. So pretty exciting.
I think the vision is to be able to make an international payment as cheap and easy as pulling up a web page, like something that you would do without even thinking about the mechanics or the costs or who has to do what. It's just so automatic and so cheap and so scalable, and there's so many of them happening that it's almost invisible. You don't even think about doing it.
Yeah, almost like the value is moving with the data, just right on top of each other. And that is a world that we can have, but not with the infrastructure you have today. You've got kind of an internet world, kind of working with a pre-internet world of money, and those things are not lining up. So this is a big bottleneck for the world. If we can push through this, that's it. And again, blockchains are not the only answer. A subset of the solution. But the broader solution combines this kind of value interoperability protocols with a super fast and efficient digital asset, and then with some kind of mechanism for programming how that value moves around.